A severe psychological effect as a result of stress is post-traumatic stress disorder, or PTSD. Symptoms of PTSD include nightmares, flashbacks, reliving the traumatic event, loss of interest in important activities, hypervigilance, and difficulty concentrating. PTSD is common in people returning home from military service and also in civilians in war zones. PTSD is a majorly disruptive disorder. PTSD is also common in people who work in emergency services. For example, people who are first responders to car accidents, such as ambulance workers and police officers. Those suffering from PTSD need extra support through counselling and other professional help. There was some concern around September 11 that the massive television coverage of the terrorist attacks back then would produce an outbreak of PTSD around the world, because people thought that maybe you can be traumatised and develop PTSD through viewing media coverage about the event. There's no strong evidence suggesting that adults are susceptible to PTSD via media coverage, but young children can be. So the advice is still, when there are tragic events showing on the news, we really shouldn't let young children watch the news. To give you a sense of the scope of PTSD, Hogan colleagues looked at the number of soldiers who developed PTSD after they returned home from Iraq and Afghanistan. They estimated between 15.6% to 17.1% of those who had returned home from Iraq and 11.2% of those who returned home from Afghanistan had PTSD. When you think about the large number of people who served in those war zones, that's actually a lot of people. In 2007, it was estimated that approximately 300,000 former service members developed PTSD after returning home from war. Due to the symptoms that are associated with the condition, it can be difficult for soldiers suffering from PTSD after returning home to reintegrate back into their community. It's an incredibly debilitating condition. Other than PTSD, problems that people sometimes experience from prolonged stress include sleep disturbances, sexual difficulties, poor academic or workplace performance, and alcohol and drug abuse. Some disorders that are triggered by chronic stress include depression, anxiety, schizophrenia, and eating disorders. Stress can make people more susceptible to them. Now, these are all negative effects of stress, but there are some positive effects of stress. Susan Folkman and her research team have looked at stress experienced by people whose partners were diagnosed with a terminal illness. Living and caring for a loved one who's dying is extremely traumatic for people. However, Folkman found people who were able to navigate their way through the traumatic period and come out the other side and dealt with the stress actually developed a set of new skills. They had re-evaluated priorities and an enhanced self-concept. After these people who had been through the traumatic experience of losing a loved one, when they experienced subsequent stress, they dealt with it in a more constructive way. They were able to respond to stress more effectively, and they were not as badly affected by day-to-day stresses. So people can actually come out of stressful events with new skills and resilience, and these are the positive effects of stress.